Come, Senate will come to order. I ask all present to please rise and join with me as we recite the Pledge of Allegiance to our flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Today's invocation will be offered by the Reverend Brandon McLaughlin, pastor of St. Charles African Methodist Episcopal Zion Church in Sparkhill.
Bow our heads for a word of prayer. God of creation, you spoke and showed us the power of words. You touched dust and showed us the power of steadfast love. Help us to be mindful of the two. There are those in need of us to speak with power on their behalf. Likewise, others who need love with words and deeds. Endow these leaders with the gifts of your grace. Let them see those they serve through your eyes. Let them do things for the blessings of your people. For this we give you praise. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor. Thank you. Reading of the journal.
In Senate Tuesday, May 15th, the Senate met pursuant to adjournment. The journal of Monday, May 14th was read and approved. On motion, Senate adjourned.
Without objection, journal will stand approved as read. Presentation of petitions. Messages from the Assembly. Secretary will read.
On page 63, Senator Marchione moved to discharge the Committee on Local Government, Assembly Bill number 10347, and substitute the identical Senate Bill 8164, third reading calendar 950.
Substitution so ordered.
On page 65, Senator Golden moved to discharge the Committee on Higher Education, Assembly Bill number 9728, and substitute the identical Senate Bill 7616, third reading calendar 972.
Substitution so ordered. Messages from the Governor. Reports of standing committees. Reports of select committees, communication and reports from state officers, motions and resolutions. Senator DeFrancisco.
Yes, first I'd like to all those in hearing of this microphone, I would like to invite all the legislators of the Senate to join us for this important meeting today. There are several resolutions honoring people that are that should be honored. And there is some very substantial legislation that we have to pass. So if you are within the hearing of my voice and you're a member of the Senate, please join us. On page 32, I offer the following amendments to calendar number 398, Senate print 7166A by Senator Ritchie, and ask that said bill retain its place on a third reading calendar.
Amendments are received. The bill shall retain its place on a third reading calendar.
Would you please recognize Senator Klein?
Senator Klein.
Thank you, Mr. President. On behalf of Senator Carlucci, I move to recommit Senate Bill print number 2649, calendar number 1080, on the order of third reading to the Committee on Commerce, Economic Development, Small Business, with instructions to strike out the enacting clause.
So ordered. Senator DeFrancisco.
Please take up previously adopted resolution 4327 by Senator Bonasek. I'll read in its entirety and call on Senator Bonasek, Seward and Akshar to speak.
Secretary will read.
Legislative resolution number 4327 by Senator Bonasek, congratulating the Delaware Academy varsity girls basketball team and head coach Todd Bruce upon the occasion of catching the New York State Public High School Athletic Association Class D Girls Basketball Championship. Whereas individual and team championships are highly sought after in high school sports, this legislative body commends rare athletic achievements and pays special recognition to those who pursue such excellence and become examples of the youth of this great Empire State. And whereas athletic competition helps to enhance both the moral and physical development of young athletes, preparing them for the future by instilling in them the importance of teamwork, encouraging a standard of healthy living, and developing a sense of fair play and competition. And whereas this legislative body is justly proud to congratulate the Delaware Academy varsity girls basketball team and head coach Todd Bruce upon the occasion of capturing the New York State Public High School Athletic Association Class D Girls Basketball Championship. To the praise and applause of their excited fans, the Bulldogs defeated Franklinville High School in an exciting 54-51 victory to capture the championship. And whereas proudly donning the school's colors of maroon and white, family, friends, and community at large loyally and enthusiastically supported the Bulldogs throughout their journey as they ended their season with an impressive 24-2 overall record. And whereas in a sport such as basketball, which demands athletic prowess, speed, and agility, head coach Todd Bruce and assistant coach A.J. Musciaro and Tom Glidden worked hard to hone the skills of this championship team, teaching these outstanding athletes lessons which will prove invaluable both on and off the court. And whereas head coach Todd Bruce and all the outstanding athletes on the Delaware Academy varsity girls basketball team have clearly utilized dedication, determination, and teamwork in providing a lasting contribution to the spirit of excellence, which is a tradition of their school. Now, therefore, be it resolved that this legislative body pauses deliberations to congratulate the members of the Delaware Academy varsity girls basketball team, Logan Bruce, Eileen Nealis, Hannah Baxter, Olivia Watkin, Caitlin Finch, Anna Post, Regan Bracci, Sella Schnabel, Brianna Gioff, Sylvia Little, Julia Burns, Meredith Mabel, Caroline Grace, and Sophia Watkin. Head coach Todd Bruce and assistant coaches A.J. Musciaro and Tom Glidden upon the occasion of capturing the New York State Public High School Athletic Association Class D Girls Basketball Championship. And be it further resolved that copies of this resolution suitably engrossed be transmitted to the members of the Delaware Academy varsity girls basketball team, head coach Todd Bruce, assistant coaches A.J. Musciaro and Tom Glidden, manager Bree Sons, statistician Mercedes Watkin, athletic director Jeff Ferrara, and superintendent Jason D. Thompson.
Senator Bonasack on the resolution.
Thank you, Mr. President. I'd like to welcome our champions for section D, Division D, I should say, Jason Thompson, our superintendent, and the names of all the young ladies are red. It will be forever in our Senate minutes. And before I talk about your basketball prowess, I'd like to congratulate five of you who play on this basketball team that won the section title in soccer. So we have talented athletes up in the gallery. I myself am a former college basketball player, so I read with excitement the articles in the newspaper of how you won this game. And I love the picture when you were in the celebration, mauling each other, jumping on each other with such excitement. But what I liked was you were down in the game against an undefeated team who had never lost all season, Franklinville, 25-0. So this is the championship game. There's little less than 6 seconds, and you're down by three. So the coach says to his daughter, you got to take a three-point shot. She goes, I'm not a three-point shooter. I like to drive. He says, what are you here for? So this young lady, and I don't mean to single her out only, but I thought it was kind of interesting, the byplay, and every member contributes to this victory. She goes above the top of the key, a step back three-pointer, and hits to put the game in overtime. And she says, it's the first time I ever stepped back and hit a three-point over a shot, and that put the game in a tie in regulation. You went on to win 54-51. What an exciting, tremendous victory. Those moments are priceless. You will remember it for the rest of your life, and I congratulate each and every one of you. Thank you.
Senator Sir. Ladies, we're going to clap again for you because Senator Seward wants to be heard on the resolution as well. Senator Seward.
Thank you, Mr. President. I want to join Senator Bonasek in not only welcoming our Delaware Academy Bulldogs to the chamber here today, but also to congratulate you on the great achievement that you have obtained. I'm very, very pleased that a portion of the Delaware Academy school district is in my Senate district, so we sort of share Delaware Academy, and this is a very proud moment for all of us, for sure. This team is made up of what I call true trailblazers, because they are the very first state basketball champs from Delaware Academy. So you are really trailblazers, no question about it. This winter, as Senator Bonasek so ably described, and I feel like we were right at the game the way he described it. It was a thrilling 54-51 win over Franklinville to capture the state championships. And our apologies to our colleague Senator Young, who represents Franklinville. This is a team, though, that had a goal, and they worked very, very hard to achieve it. There are plenty of extra hours of practice in the Delaware Academy gymnasium, and I think probably in a few driveways around the school district, shooting some hoops right at home for further practice. The team put the work in, and the result was a much sought-after state title, a true crowning achievement for this outstanding group of young ladies. Of course, the girls were not alone in their journey. They had plenty of help, constant guidance from their coaches, and loving encouragement of parents and other family members, and of course, the enthusiastic support of the entire community in the Delaware Academy School District. You made us all proud. Along with their success on the basketball court, however, these girls also excel in the classroom. They were recently named a New York State Public High School Athletic Association Scholar Athlete team. Truly, they epitomize the term a student athlete. And as I think about the future and the great achievements of this team, I have very optimistic about the future because you epitomize. We're going to have a great future as we go forward. So the 2018 Delaware Academy Bulldogs, they are champions both on and off the court. So we're delighted to join in sponsorship of this resolution and stand to congratulate you on a great season. Congratulations.
Thank you, Senator Seward. Senator Bailey on the resolution.
Thank you, Mr. President. For the record, John, I can't hit a step back either. I tried it yesterday and it didn't work out so well. But I am a fan of basketball, but the reason why I'm such a fan of basketball, not just for the artistry of the sport, but for the team aspect that it brings to us and the life lesson that you learn on the court. And while I was never the greatest athlete, basketball taught me a lot about myself. And as a father of two daughters, I really have grown to love and appreciate the game of women's basketball. One of my favorite players is actually Sue Bird and Diana Taurasi. They're two amazing players. Becky Hammon should be the coach of an NBA team very soon. And I encourage young women to continue to play basketball and to continue to participate in athletics, because it will make you more well-rounded. And I'm not that I'm pushing my three-year-old in that direction, but I'm gently nudging her. Maybe from time to time I put a basketball in the crib when she was sleeping. I may or may have not done that. My 16-month-old, you know, she likes to dunk on the Fisher Price hoop in the house. But you young ladies are an example of what they can be, and it's inspiring to see champions both on and off the court, as Senator Seward and Senator Bonasek was saying, that your academic achievements are equally and probably more important than your accomplishments on the court. So I want to congratulate you all and on the championship and many more, and hopefully some of you will go on to play college basketball and go on to the WNBA or overseas if that's within your dreams, but never stop dreaming and keep reaching. God bless and congratulations.
Thank you, Senator Bailey. To the team, we congratulate you on all of your accomplishments. We welcome you to the New York State Senate. This chamber is yours, of course. We extend all of the privileges and courtesies of this great house. I'd ask all the members to rise once again and congratulate these fine young ladies. Senator DeFrancisco.
That resolution is open for co-sponsorship. If you'd like to co-sponsor, please notify the desk.
Resolution is open for co-sponsorship. If you'd like to be a co-sponsor, please notify the desk.
Can we please take up previously adopted Resolution 5246 by Senator Flanagan, read it its entirety, and call on Senator Stewart Cousins and then Senator Flanagan to speak.
Secretary will read.
Legislative Resolution number 5246 by Senator Flanagan, honoring the hard work, dedication, and commitment of the members of the New York State Legislative Messenger Service. Whereas, it's the sense of this legislative body to honor individuals who have faithfully served the people and the government of the state of New York with dedication and conscientious service. And whereas, the New York State Legislative Messenger Service was founded in 1973 as an avenue to provide job training and opportunities to individuals with a disability, emphasis is placed on understanding and amplifying an individual's strengths while providing support, training, and structure to lessen any barriers created by their disability. And whereas this outstanding service plays a very important role in expediting the work of the New York State Legislature. And whereas technology has reshaped how the Legislative Messenger Service performs their job with induction on online ordering and the integration of tablets in 2015, which are being used by over 95% of the staff daily. And whereas this legislative body is justly proud to honor the hard work, dedication, and commitment of the members of the New York State Legislative Messenger Service. And whereas for more than four decades, the New York State Legislative Messenger Service, located in the Legislative Office Building, has provided a communications network throughout the Empire State Plaza and neighboring state buildings for Senate and Assembly legislators and their staffs. And whereas the dedicated members of the New York State Legislative Messenger Service can always be relied on to provide swift and dependable service. And whereas under the able leadership of Kevin Cather, Director, and Beth Bonesteel, Assistant Director, the members of the New York State Legislative Messenger Service whom we see hurrying about their rounds include Brian Abreu, Greta Amodio, Michael Cohen, William Crow, Michelle Daly, Adam Denenberg, Robert DeCiano, Sharon Forkutis, Marcus Gagnon, William Gerard, Catherine Griffin, Kenesha Hardy, Kimberly Lapp, Barbara McDonald, Kathy O'Brien, Patrick O'Hara, Kajita Oliver, Francis Rotundo, Kathleen Shalish, Molly Shook, Kelsey Wickham, Barbara Watowitz, and Valerie Zay. And whereas an apprenticeship was created in 2012 to provide opportunities for individuals with disabilities who are eager to gain professional employment experience. This year's apprentices include Molly Fortin, Alan Howard, and Jude Kalar. And whereas this legislative body is pleased to recognize and pay just tribute to the members of the New York State Legislative Messenger Service individuals who embody the true American spirit, demonstrating personal determination and significantly contributing to the workings of the New York State Legislature. Now, therefore, be it resolved that this legislative body pauses deliberations to honor the hard work, dedication, and commitment of the members of the New York State Legislative Messenger Service. And be it further resolved that copies of this resolution, suitably engrossed, be transmitted to the members of the New York State Legislative Messenger Services and the aforementioned apprentices.
Senator Stewart Cousins.
Yes. Thank you, Mr. President. I rise and certainly thank Senator Flanagan for putting forth this resolution, which I believe speaks to everything our messengers bring to us on a day-to-day basis. We are all very, very busy people, and we always talk about how our staff really makes it easier for us. But without the information coming between offices, without the information getting there on a timely basis, without us knowing that we could rely on you and your services and your talent, our jobs would be so much harder. And although there are a lot of employees here, there are very few that have overcome the kinds of obstacles that sometimes you have to overcome to be part of this family. And so I want to thank all of you on behalf of my colleagues here in the Senate Democrats to say thank you. You are talented, you are gifted, you are necessary, and I'm hoping that people all over will take a look at you and the example that you set and make sure that we expand opportunities, because there is so much that you have to contribute and have contributed to making New York State work. So congratulations, thank you so much, and we won't have a chance together to wish each other a good summer, but again, enjoy the summer, and thank you for your service to the state.
Thank you. Thank you, Senator Stewart Cousins. Senator Flanagan.
Thank you, Mr. President. I rise to speak on behalf of this resolution. I want to direct my attention for a moment to the young students who are up in the gallery. You heard from Senator Bonasik, Senator Seward, and I played basketball with Senator Bonasik. I was a much better passer than I was a shooter, and he was actually a very good basketball player. I know it's hard to believe, but he was a good basketball player. But the point I want to make is it is wonderful to see you in the gallery. For a variety of reasons, not the least of which is you are ambassadors to your community, to your school district, and we're proud to see people like you, even if we may not know you. So props and kudos to you. But I want to explain why we're honoring the folks that are here today. There's a commercial on TV that involves the Norfolk and CSX railroads, and there's a couple of people talking about what they're doing. And at the end, one guy says, so basically, what are you doing? He just says with a smile on his face, just keeping the trains running, making sure things work, making sure things go smoothly. Now, that's going to seem contradictory to what I'm going to say. Right now, the wheels of government have halted. They stopped. There's nothing going on because the messengers are not at their appointed rounds. So nothing, you know, there is no productive work that is getting done, because the people who do the work are here being honored. So I certainly want to add my voice to that of Senator Stewart Cousins. We are delighted to have you with us and amongst us. To Kevin and Beth, thank you for your guidance and your supervisory capacity and your leadership. Let's give them a round of applause. Now, there are two individuals, and it's always a little difficult if you single people out, as Senator Bonasik said, but there are two individuals who deserve another ounce of recognition. Ken LaValle is one of our dear colleagues. Ken LaValle walks around, he's like, hey, I'm the Dean of the Senate, I got 42 years, I'm the most senior person here. Barbara McDonald, where's Barbara? Barbara? Okay. I'm pretty sure I checked for the record, 43 years. Am I correct? No? Barbara, how many years do you have? Okay. Well, we have two of our members, one with 43, and Frank, Mr. Rotundo. He is the dean of the messenger service. And as an extension, I see my buddy Adam over there. Adam, good to see you. And we have a resident in-house artist. I get to see Billy Crow every morning. He stops by my office. On my birthday, he gives me a hand-done portrait. And he's always got a smile on his face. And you know what? It is really, for me personally, and I think I'm characteristic of the man. There we go. Senator Marchione has a framed picture from Billy. You all make us look good, you make us look better, and you make us feel good. So to all of you, thank you for who you are, for what you do. Keep up the good work, and it's fantastic to see all of you here. Mr. President, thank you.
Thank you, Senator Flanagan. Senator Robach on the resolution.
Yes, Mr. President. Let me to rise quickly. Just this is such a great resolution, and thank Senator Cousins for her words, Senator Flanagan for the resolution. I just want to add, besides the important work that you guys do, I really want to thank you for really the style you do it, your friendship, and really being part of the Senate family. And it's true. Adam gives me the Mets update every day so I know what's going on. Marcus keeps me smiling. Marcus, as a matter of fact, may have saved Senator Lanza's life. One day I wanted to maybe be a little bit mad at him, but Marcus said, just let it go, just let it go. So you're always, your smiles, your updates, telling us what's going on, above and beyond, delivering everything you do. Thank you for being the great people you are, being so awesome. You're inspiring, and we love you.
Thank you, Senator Robach. Senator Breslin on the resolution.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. And in my case, you are my co-workers, my friends, and you're my constituents in many cases. And in many cases, I know all your relatives, and I get together with your relatives. And I see Kathleen, the first person there, and waving, Kathleen. And if you say hi to her, how's your day going? And she'll turn and smile and say, so far, so good, right? And Molly. And next to her, wait, Molly. Oh, said Barbara. Oh, okay, and I can go down and down and down. Billy Crow. Billy Crow and his whole family I've known for over 50 years. And Billy, you do a phenomenal job. And Greta, where are you, Greta? There's Greta back there. And Michael Cohen, who I know very well. Michael, you all know Michael. And Michelle Daly. Who's a great singer, is that Michelle? And Adam. Adam always stops me and gives me the different bus routes that we need improved in the area. And back on the left, Kate Griffin, my dear friend Kate, who I've known her family for many, 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 many years. And I can go on and on. You're all very, very special. And you're my coworkers. Most importantly, you brighten my day every day. If it's not one, it's the other. Molly, you can say hello to me from a football field away, can't you? And there's a story for each one of you, and all those stories are positive. And all those stories make this a better place to live and work. Because you brighten our day. There's no, when it comes to the you guys, there's no Democrats and Republicans. They're your fellow friends and workers. So I love you all. Keep it up. You've done a phenomenal job, and you'll continue to do it. Thanks.
Thank you, Senator Breslin. Senator Marchione on the resolution.
Thank you, Mr. President. I just rise to add my thanks to all that you do here. You know, I tell the story that when I first became senator, it was one of you who invited me over for dinner the first time. And you are just such special people, and you do an amazing job for us. And I love working with you. But I have to tell you how much I love you being part of the Senate family. as Senator Breslin said and others, just to meet you in the hall and to say hello. And Billy, I did bring my birthday card that you drew for me. And I'm grateful for the smiles that we get in the morning, the stress that we all face here, and you as well. But to have a smiling face in the halls in the morning, just to stop and say hello, how is your day, means more than you will ever know. I'm grateful to have had the opportunity to work with everyone here, but especially with all of you. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Marchione. Senator Todisco on the resolution.
Mr. President, well, to quote someone from Saturday Night Live, you look marvelous. Really do. I want to thank all of our messengers. And you know, I spent a lot of time in this building, not necessarily in this room, but on the other side for most of my time. And tremendous service you've given us in the assembly and myself. And I was wondering when I came over here, well, would I get that same level of service? And I have to tell you, it is above and beyond the level of service that I've ever seen on the other side. You do a tremendous job for all of us. And I kind of liken you to the Postal Service and a postal worker. You know what the slogan is? I paraphrase, rain, sleet, snow, nothing can stop you from getting to your intended quarters to serve us. And you know why you're better than the Postal Service? You never charge me for a stamp when you deliver all this. It's all for free. 25 cents? Well, that was way back, 24. But you are dedicated, you're hardworking, you have a tremendous work ethic, and I consider you some of the best public servants in the state of New York and some of the best state workers in the state of New York because, as has been mentioned, we couldn't do our job as public servants if you didn't do your job as public servants. And I want to say to all of you, we appreciate you, we thank you. Now, Barbara, I have a little bit of a concern. You know, there are some rules. You were here 43 years, and you know there are some rules to becoming a messenger. And I want to know how you got this job at the age of 12. Because, you know, we're going to allow for that. We're going to provide a waiver. But you do look marvelous. And let me close by saying this. If any one of you, and I mean it, any one of you, ever need a recommendation from myself for any other position, for any other thing, any other job you go towards, or anything you do in life, just come over, just ask me. I think any member of this room will write out a recommendation for you. Now, there's just one caveat to that. I cannot write a recommendation to any one of you who is from my district who wants me to write a recommendation to run for the 49th senatorial district, because I'd have to be your campaign manager, because I couldn't win against any one of you. God bless you and congratulate you, and thank you so much.
Thank you, Senator Todisco. Senator Breslin made a very salient point. It's not about Republican or Democrat. We're all stood up, and all of us, on behalf of this very grateful body and all the people who work for us, we appreciate you, and we thank you for your hard work. It's been said many times today, but it certainly bears repeating. We all want you to know that you are part of the Senate family. To my colleagues on the floor, please rise and give these ladies and gentlemen a very big round of applause. Senator DeFrancisco.
Yes, thank you, Mr. President. This resolution is open for co-sponsorship, and in view of the reaction and the desire of everyone to speak here, unfortunately, there's not enough time. I'll suggest that everybody be put on as a co-sponsor, unless you do not want to be a co-sponsor on this piece of this resolution.
So everybody will be on this resolution. In the event that you feel it necessary to take yourself off, please notify the desk. Senator DeFrancisco.
Could we please take up a previously adopted resolution 4517 by Senator Serino? Read the title only and call on Senator Serino to speak.
The secretary will read.
May we have some order in the chambers here?
Just a little bit of order. I'm sorry.
Can we please ask Senator Robach to leave the chambers for a moment?
Senator Robach, either have a seat or go out in the hallway, please. The secretary will read.
Legislative resolution number 4517 by Senator Serino, memorializing Governor Andrew M. Cuomo to proclaim May 2018 as Lyme Disease Awareness Month in the state of New York.
Senator Serino on the resolution.
Thank you, Mr. President. Each year I have stood during this month as we recognize May as Lyme Disease Awareness Month. But this year I rise with an even more heightened sense of urgency. Did you know that the CDC recently released a report showing that the number of people getting diseases from ticks and mosquitoes has tripled since the early 2000s? Diseases like Lyme and other tick-borne illnesses. What's worse, the CDC found that our country is not fully prepared to control the relentless spread. The numbers don't lie. New York sits at the epicenter of the Lyme and tick-borne disease epidemic. The Senate has led the charge against this epidemic for years, and this year we fought to include an unprecedented $1 million to bolster education, prevention, and research initiatives. Today, we will take up a package of critical bills aimed to tackle these diseases by increasing awareness, improving diagnostics, better protect our children, improving important information available to homeowners looking to protect their properties, and working towards providing insurance coverage for those who are suffering. I am so appreciative to my colleagues here in our House who helped to champion these important initiatives, especially the chair of our Health Committee, Senator Kemp Hannan, who has been a leader on this issue right from the beginning. Today, we will be holding a Lyme Task Force meeting, the calling of which prompted the governor's office to announce yesterday a series of important initiatives they will be taking up to help the cause. It has been a long time coming, but it is clear that this issue is finally getting the attention it deserves here in New York. As many of you know, I hail from Hyde Park in the Hudson Valley, and our area in particular has been hit particularly hard. Back home, I have heard story after devastating story of people whose lives have been forever changed by Lyme disease. And you know, look up, we have children here in the gallery. Every time I have kids come from the district, I ask them, I say, how many of you know about ticks and Lyme disease? And Commissioner Zuckerman and I have had this conversation. About a third of the kids raise their hand. That's why we're doing this education. And what really hits home, I know as a parent, I had a little girl, she was in fourth grade, and she said, Senator Serino, I have arthritic Lyme. Arthritic Lyme, she had trouble moving her hands. This is a reality. That's why it's so imperative that we are championing this and passing these bills today, because the frustration and anxiety that comes with this struggle is very real. Today, we take a significant step forward to help those who are suffering and to more effectively prevent more New Yorkers from being impacted. I hope you will join me in spreading the word about Lyme, and I thank my colleagues for making Lyme disease a priority. And if anyone wants to take part in the Take a Bite Out of Lyme Challenge, come see me after session and we'll set you up with some limes. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Senator Serino. Senator Hannan on the resolution.
Thank you, Mr. President. This is the most significant type of resolution because Lyme disease has proven to be one of the more irascible types of diseases. It's hard to detect, it's hard to prevent, it's hard to treat. Senator Serino had a task force, had a round table in the fall, and it was amazing the non-consensus there is among the medical community as to how to do the detection and how to do the treatment.
And yet, since then, we've found out that there are more diseases borne by ticks. It's wider spread in New York and other states. The CDC is really perking up. So the leadership, the Senate and Senator Serino have shown, is significant. Money has been put in the budget. There is an agenda today with some significant advances. And with all the other types of concerns that get articulated, that get articulated in the paper, this really should be a top priority for public health. So I urge the adoption of this resolution. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Hannan. Senator Young.
Thank you, Mr. President. I rise in support of this resolution, but also to commend our colleagues, people like Senator Sue Serino, Senator Hannan, who have worked so hard on these issues. And we have made great progress in addressing Lyme disease, but there's so much further to go. About 6 months ago, I received a call from one of my dear friends. I hadn't spoken to him in a long time. What I found out was his son, for 4 years, young man, at the very beginning of his adult life, had been bedridden for about 4 years. They took him to doctors in New York. They took him to doctors in California. They went to every medical expert they could find, and they could not find the cause for his dire illness. Finally, they found out it was due to Lyme disease. And unfortunately, there's family after family after family in New York State that is dealing with the crippling, devastating effects of Lyme disease. And that's why we are taking action in New York State. We have several programs, grant funding. We want to prevent people from getting the disease. We want to be able to treat it in the proper manner. And again, I commend Senator Serino. She has been a champion on this issue. Senator Amador has been. Senator Murphy has been. And Senator O'Mara has been. And but all of the members have worked together to make progress. And I couldn't be prouder to be a part of this body because of how we get things done here in the state of New York. And again, we need to continue this battle. Today is a great day, but we need to continue to win this fight against Lyme disease. Thank you, Mr. President.
Senator Young, thank you. Senator Boyle on a resolution.
Mr. President, in support of the resolution, I'd first like to thank my colleague, Senator Serino, for her leadership on this issue, and Senator Hannan. I represent Fire Island, a large part of Fire Island, where Lyme disease and tick-borne illnesses have been a problem for many years. And I can tell you that at the hearings that took place, I urge all my colleagues to watch the video if you were not able to attend this. One of my constituents, Martin Wilson, intelligent, successful business person who suffered, was misdiagnosed, and finally diagnosed with Lyme disease years later. It's devastated his life, but he's a true advocate, and I want to thank him for his efforts. This is just the beginning. This resolution I strongly support, and this package of bills, we're going to get this passed today with Senator Serino's leadership and move on and finally cure Lyme disease and all tick-borne illnesses.
Thank you, Senator Boyle. Senator Amador on the resolution.
Thank you, Mr. President. I want to thank Senator Serino and her leadership, not just for this resolution, but the leadership on the task force on Lyme tick-borne diseases. There's no question that she has elevated and raised the awareness and also advocated for much needed funds. Representing part of the Hudson Valley and the Capital Region, we have a major problem. We have a major problem with our constituents who suffer from a tick-borne disease or just a little tick bite or Lyme disease that they don't know where the cure, what the cure, or why they feel the way they do, and physicians not being properly able to diagnose the right diagnoses. I believe that what we're doing, what Senator Serino has been doing, will go a long way here in the state of New York. We have to put more resources, more dedication, more thought. We need to listen to our constituents and to the professionals throughout the state of New York to try to bring a solution to this painful, painful situation that we see in the state of New York. And we know that the state of New York faces a large population, deer herd, as well as a major problem with ticks. So I thank Senator Serino, and for you, Mr. President, allowing the resolution
to be heard today.
Thank you, Senator Amador. Senator Marchione?
Mr. President, I rise also to thank Senator Hannon and Senator Sue. I'm thrilled that they put the time that they put into this issue. You know, you go back home, any one of us, I have Columbia County, we kind of refer to it as ground zero for tick disease, and it is such a serious issue for everyone. But you know, one of the brochures that we got out talk about little boys 6 to 10 or that age that are outside playing, they're the most susceptible. That's a real scare. That's a real scare to all of us, but certainly myself as a grandmother who have four boys ranging between 6 and 10, you see them. They're out in the woods, they're playing just like we did, but now it's dangerous. I thank you, Sue, for all, Senator Serino, for all that you do, all that you have been doing, the leadership that you've given this issue. And this package of bills is terrific, spearheaded by you and by Senator Hannon, and all the efforts that have been put into this is a critically important issue to our district and to the people we represent. Thank you so much for that.
Thank you, Senator Marchione. Senator DeFrancisco?
Is open for co-sponsorship. If you want a co-sponsor, please notify the desk.
The resolution is open for co-sponsorship. If you'd like to be a co-sponsor, please notify the desk.
All right. On page 77, I offer the following amendments to calendar 1120 by and calendar 1120, Senate Print 7949 by Senator Serino, and ask that that bill retain its place on the third reading calendar.
That amendment is received. The bill shall retain its place on the third reading calendar.
Now can we take up previously adopted resolution 4520 by Senator Little, read it in its entirety, and call on Senator Little to speak.
Secretary will read.
Legislative resolution number 4520 by Senator Little, congratulating the Lake George Varsity Boys basketball team and head coach Dave Jones upon the occasion of capturing the New York State Public High School Athletic Association Class C Boys Basketball Championship. Whereas individual and team championships are highly sought after in high school sports, this legislative body commends rare athletic achievements and pays special recognition to those who pursue such excellence and become examples for the youth of this great Empire State. And whereas athletic competition helps to enhance both the moral and physical development of young athletes, preparing them for the future by instilling in them the importance of teamwork, encouraging a standard of healthy living, and developing a sense of fair play and competition. And whereas this legislative body is justly proud to congratulate the Lake George Varsity Boys basketball team and head coach Dave Jones upon the occasion of capturing the New York State Public High School Athletic Association Class C Boys Basketball Championship. To the praise and applause of their excited fans, the Warriors defeated North Star Christian Academy in an exciting 66-65 victory to win their third championship in 6 years on Saturday, March 17, 2018, at the Floyd L. Maines Veterans Memorial Arena in Binghamton, New York. And whereas proudly donning the school's colors of blue and white, family, friends, and the community at large loyally and enthusiastically supported the Warriors throughout their journey as they ended their season with an impressive 28-0 overall record. And whereas in a sport such as basketball, which demands athletic prowess and speed and agility, head coach Dave Jones and assistant coach Tim Kassane worked hard to hone the skills of this championship team, teaching these outstanding athletes lessons which will prove invaluable both on and off the court. And whereas head coach Dave Jones and all of the outstanding athletes on the Lake George Varsity Boys basketball team have clearly utilized dedication, determination, and teamwork in providing a lasting contribution to the spirit of excellence, which is a tradition of their school. Now, therefore, be it resolved that this legislative body pause in the deliberations to congratulate the members of the Lake George Varsity Boys basketball team, Jacob Helms, Connor Vanansky, Alex Leonelli, Colin Leonelli, Kagan Helms, Mike Johnson, Alec Jones, Daniel Pusher, Mason Flatley, Nick Hofus, Caleb Schreim, and Chris Becker. Head coach Dave Jones, assistant coach Tim Kassane, upon the occasion of capturing the New York State Public High School Athletic Association Class C Boys Basketball Championship, and be it further resolved that copies of this resolution suitably engrossed be transmitted to the members of the Lake George Varsity Boys Basketball Team, head coach Dave Jones and assistant coach Tim Kassane.
Senator Little on the resolution.
Thank you, Mr. President. And let me say, welcome back to the Lake George basketball team. This is their second time here in the Senate chamber receiving recognition for a fantastic season and the Class C state championship. On this team and in Lake George, they are a very athletic school district and many sports and many achievements. And they've also had many individual stars. But this is a team that really doesn't have a lot of individual stars. They are all the stars. And every single athlete here has participated and been a factor in winning games. A 28-0 record is an amazing achievement because they go beyond and they play teams above the Class C as well. So I'm really happy to have them here. And I'd like to do a little special recognition of their coach, Dave Jones, who has been the coach for many, many years, but is retiring this year. Dave Jones has had something that I think most coaches would love to be and have. He has had the ability to coach his three sons and one daughter in sports at Lake George High School. And that's a privilege that not every coach gets, nor does every father get that. So that's an award-winning thing all by itself. Accompanying them today, we also have with us Kyle Manny, who is the director of athletics, Blake White, who is also an assistant coach, and Tara Sullivan, who does their communications. The whole community came out once again for this team and celebrated. The parade was kind of stymied because of rain, but we celebrated in the Lake George Gymnasium, and it was just a wonderful event where everybody got to participate. And the thing they like to do the most is cut down that net. So each and every one of them got a chance to get up on the ladder and cut down the net. So very, very exciting. But my hat's off to this team. There are some graduating seniors, but there are some kids who just are there. You work hard, you practice a lot, and you go out and give every game your best. And I hope you continue to do that throughout your life, whether it's in basketball or work or family activities, whatever and wherever. Always try to do your best as you have in this season. So thank you, and thank you, Mr. President, for recognizing them.
Thank you, Senator Little, Coach Jones, your assistants, all the athletes that are with us. We congratulate you on behalf of all of your accomplishments. We, too, welcome you to this great chamber, which is your chamber. And I'd ask everybody in the chamber, please rise and congratulate these fine young men on their accomplishments. Senator DeFrancisco.
Yes, that is also open for co-sponsorship. If you'd like to co-sponsor, please notify the desk.
The resolution is open for co-sponsorship. If you want to be a co-sponsor, please notify the desk.
Can we now take up the reading of the non-controversial calendar?
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 123 by Senator Robach. Senator Print 287, Act Amended Domestic Relations Law.
Read the last section. Section Senator four, DeFrancisco.
Section 4, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Senator DeFrancisco, I'm sorry, you're just voting no or you wish to be heard?
That's a no.
For which one of my questions, sir?
First one.
Got it. Announce the result.
Ayes 59, nays 1. Senator DeFrancisco recorded in the negative.
Bill is passed. Senator DeFrancisco.
I just would like to explain my no vote. This bill is a great bill if it dealt with only the issue of whether or not somebody was convicted of a rape. It seems to me it's a no-brainer. If you're convicted of a rape, you should not be of the person who bore a child, you should certainly not be even considered for custody or visitation and the like. But this is broader than that. It's talk about an individual cannot even be considered for visitation if the person is charged with a crime. There used to be a presumption of innocence. There used to be innocent until proven guilty. In the good old days, you were in a trial and you weren't convicted until the jury said you were. And it just seems to me judges are smart enough that if there's a risk to a child, the judge who's determining visitation or custody will be able to make that determination and not be the hands being tied based on a law that says you have to deny this to an individual custody or visitation if there's even a charge. So for that reason, I vote no. I would vote yes if it was just for convictions. Thank you.
Senator DeFrancisco, you'll be recorded in the negative. Senator Stavisky to explain her vote.
I'm going to vote for the bill, but I also want to express my concerns somewhat along the lines of what Senator DeFrancisco described. There are situations where parents who have been convicted of raping a woman get custody of, or visitation rights and custody of the child. And I think that's an area of tremendous concern. I've had legislation on this issue, and I really wish that we would go a lot deeper into this, make this a issue of concern, work with the Assembly, and try to come up with some legislation that upon conviction, that a parent can never get custody of the child if the child is a victim of that rape. Thank you, Mr. President.
Senator Stavisky to be recorded in the negative. Senator Krueger to, excuse me,
in the affirmative. Affirmative.
Excuse me. Senator Krueger to explain her vote.
Thank you. I'm going to vote no, because I think I did misread the bill until explained by Senator DeFrancisco. I do believe this state needs to do much more to protect victims of sexual assault and rape, and there are many changes we should make in our laws to do so. But I have to agree with the senator that we need to ensure due process, and if someone has not been found guilty as charged, it's a serious question why we in the state should be explicit that they cannot have visitation. I share his view that judges are capable of hearing arguments for and against visitation on many levels, and if someone has been accused but not yet found guilty or found innocent of a charge, I think we have to be very careful with overriding due process in our diligence to try to protect children. So I'm also voting no. Thank you, Mr. President.
Senator Krueger to be recorded in the negative. Announce the result.
Relation to calendar 123, those recorded in the negative are Senator DeFrancisco, Krueger, and Montgomery. Ayes 57, nays 3.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 186 by Senator Serrano, Senate Print 3052.
Read the last section.
Enact amend the general city law.
Call the roll.
Section 3, this act should take effect on the 30th day. Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 60.
Bill's passed.
Calendar number 607 by Senator Murphy, Senate Print 5580B. Enact amend the highway law.
Read the last section.
Section 4, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes 60.
Bill's passed.
Calendar number 680 by Senator Lavelle, Senate Print 5558, an act authorizing.
Home rule message at the desk. Secretary will read.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes 60.
Bill's passed.
Calendar number 746 by Senator Brooks, Senate Print 7399A, an act authorized.
There's a home rule message at the desk. The Secretary will read.
Section 3, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes 60.
The bill's passed.
Calendar number 768 by Senator Ort, Senate Print 7827, an act amend the highway law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes 60.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 813 by Senator Helming, Senate Print 7935A, an act amend the Uniform Justice Court Act.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes 60.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 897 by Senator Golden, Senate Print 5686A, an act authorized.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes 60.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 950 by Member of the Assembly Magnarelli, Assembly Print 10347, Enact amend Chapter 62 of the laws of 2003.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes 60.
The bill's passed.
Calendar number 956 by Senator Young, Senate Print 6883, enact amend the highway law.
Read the last section.
Section 2 of this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes 60.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 972 by Member of the Assembly Lentall, Assembly Print 9728, enact amend Chapter 548 of the laws of 2004.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes 60.
That bill is passed.
Calendar number 1029 by Senator Helming, Senate Print 6638, enact amend the workers' compensation law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
Senator Krueger to explain her vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. I'm voting no. It's possible that expanding the universe of investments for the state insurance fund might offer no risk, but the fact is the mix that we allow now clearly is working for us because our state insurance fund has actually been quite healthy and even had surpluses. And so it's not an across the board. Why would you be opposed to alternative investments that might have higher risk but still be recognized by, I think in the memo, Moody's was the example. So I remember the 2008 period when we learned that the well-respected rating agencies, Moody's, Standard & Poor's, were in fact misleading the public because they're hired by the companies who they rate, and that's just a fundamental flaw in that model. So I actually think if it's not broke, don't fix it, and we ought to keep the mix of investments as is, because clearly it's working for us now. So I vote no. Thank you, Mr. President.
Senator Krueger to be recorded in the negative. Announce the result.
Ayes 59, nays 1. Senator Krueger recorded in the negative.
Bill's passed.
Calendar number 1146 by Senator Serino, Senate Print 2588, enact amend the Environmental Conservation Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect on the 90th day.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes 60.
That bill is passed.
Calendar number 1148 by Senator LaValle, Senate Print 3816, an act authorizing.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes 60.
That bill is passed.
Calendar number 1149 by Senator Ranzenhofer, Senate Print 3880, enact amend the Environmental Conservation Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes 58, nays 2. Senators Krueger and Serrano recorded the negative.
The bill's passed.
Calendar number 1150 by Senator Hannan, Senate Print 6926, enact amend the public health law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes 60.
Bill's passed.
Calendar number 1151 by Senator Serino, Senate Print 7168, enact amend the public health law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect on the 90th day.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes 60.
That bill is passed.
Calendar number 1152 by Senator Serino, Senate Print 7169, enact amend the public health law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect on the 90th day.
You call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, DeFlanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young. Ayes 60.
Bill's passed.
Calendar number 1153 by Senator Serino, Senate Print 7208. Enact amend the public health law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes 60.
Bill's passed.
Calendar number 1154 by Senator Serino, Senate Print 7242. Enact amend the Parks, Recreation, and Historic Preservation Law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act should take effect on the 90th day.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes 60.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 1156 by Senator Serino, Senate Print 8534. Enacting the education law.
Read the last section.
Section 2 is that should take effect on the 120th day.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes, 60.
Bill is passed.
Calendar number 1157 by Senator Serino, Senate Print 8539. An act directing.
Read the last section.
Section 4, the statute should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, DeFrancisco, Flanagan, Stewart, Cousins, Young.
The results?
Ayes, 60.
Bill is passed. Senator DeFrancisco?
Would you please recognize Senator Savino for a brief introduction?
Senator Savino?
Thank you, Mr. President. I rise to offer welcome to a group of young students from my district. They have just arrived from IS 303, the Kiwanis Liberty and Government Group, and they are accompanied by their teachers, Michael Young and Mario Caggiano. So we welcome you to the Senate chamber. We hope that you had you learned something here today, and we hope that you will enjoy your time in Albany and take part in learning what goes on here in state government. We look forward to having you here, and welcome to the Senate.
We welcome you all to the Senate. We extend all the privileges and the courtesies of this great house. We hope you enjoy your visit today. Let's give them a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. I got to read this, right? Senator DeFrancisco, I made a mistake up here. We completed the reading of the non-controversial calendar.
Yes, I had recognized that. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Is there any further business at the desk?
There's no further business at the desk.
In that case, I move to adjourn until Tuesday, May 22nd at 3 p.m.
On motion, the Senate stands adjourned until Tuesday.
Intervening days being legislative days.
On motion, the Senate stands adjourned until Tuesday, May 22nd at 3 p.m., intervening days being legislative days.